That means it's not sufficient for a Catholic to say, okay, all right, I can take that. You have to give it the assent of faith. That means you have to believe it. See, faith is not something left to our free decision. In that case, we go back to those Kmart chapels, you know. We have to accept it in faith. But then when the Pope pronounces something as in the ordinary, not the extraordinary, but the ordinary magisterium, we have to obey. That doesn't mean we have to believe it, but we have to obey unless we are able to contradict what the Pope says in his ordinary teaching by quoting his predecessors, not some theologians. Don't you ever dare to contradict Pope John Paul II quoting Father Hess. Don't. I do not have the authority to correct a pope. I am correcting the pope, the present pope, today and tomorrow, with his predecessors and the councils, not with theologians. Theologians do not have that authority. That's granted only to Peter. And here Pius XII says, nor must it be thought that what is expounded in encyclical letters does not of itself demand consent, since in writing such letters the popes do not exercise the supreme power of their teaching authority. For these matters are taught with the ordinary teaching authority, of which it is true to say, he who heareth you heareth me. And generally what is expounded and inculcated in encyclical letters already for other reasons appertains to Catholic doctrine. But if the supreme pontiffs in their official documents purposely pass judgment on a matter up to the time under dispute, it is obvious that the matter, according to the mind and the will of the same pontiffs, cannot be any longer considered a question open to discussion among theologians. To explain to you what this means, when John Paul II was asked for the first time if it is possible to ordain women, he said, this is not a question that is any more open to the discussion of theologians. Now, the moment he said that, he was indeed talking according to tradition. But what happens if the present pope contradicts the ordinary teaching of his predecessors? Very simple. There cannot be any contradiction whatsoever within the ordinary teaching of the Church. So if Pius XI, in his encyclical Mortalium Animos, condemned ecumenism, and the present Pope, as John Venari explained today, desires ecumenism and preaches ecumenism, the present Pope is just simply wrong. That's it. Period. I mean, there were bad popes before. There were heretics before. We had three heretical popes before 1958 already. I'm going to talk about that later.
Okay, when I was in the business world, you always had to make an objective call on certain situations based upon the information that you had, okay, what was, you know, taught before in accordance to how someone is teaching now or how someone is acting now. You have to make objective judgments. And this is where those in a novus ordo have to understand, is that this is the reality. Okay, we have had popes who are modernists and who are liberals, who are revolutionaries, okay, who are running against what the Church has always taught. And this is just one particular aspect, although it's a grand piece of the New World Order, is that we're trying to demonstrate that the popes indeed do support this New World Order, which again is not the true world order. It has nothing to do based upon the divine law and based upon the Catholic faith. Everything is material and crass. It's just as Pope St. Pius X warned, that socialism through the new Silianist movement, ecumenism of Vatican II, that it's socialism. I mean, socialism coming down the pike, so to speak, as he had stated. So I wanted to get to, we'll throw up Pope John Paul II's famous speech. Maybe we can talk about that briefly, where he was at Gandhi's grave, and he basically makes the implication that Gandhi is in heaven.
Heritage of Mahatma Gandhi speaks to us still. And today, as a pilgrim of peace, I have come here to pay homage to Mahatma Gandhi, hero of humanity. Mahatma Gandhi thought that if all men and women, whatever the differences between them, cling to the truth with respect for the unique dignity of every human being, a new world order, a civilization of love can be achieved. May God guide us and bless us as we strive to walk together hand in hand and build together a world of peace. Mahatma Gandhi Ji Amarahen, may Gandhi live forever. Satyahinsa Amarahe, may truth and non-violence live forever.
You know, can a pope say this? Can a pope truly say that someone who rejected Jesus Christ as God, who rejects the church, can we truly say or imply that someone, you know, that this particular person, Gandhi, is in heaven? And the reference was, of course, to the New World.